WinCC version 8 step-by-step, creating the overview dynamics. In this video, we're going to create a tag for our color tank level, and we're going to hook it up to the fill level on the graphic. And we're also going to use our color structure tags to make our pumps and valves dynamic for each of the red, green, and blue supply systems. We're also going to use our tag simulator to test the animations. So we'll be able to make changes to the level, as well as test the dynamics for turning our pump on or our failure mode, or the same thing for our valves. So let's get started. First, we'll need to create a tag that will control the fill level for our tank, and we'll attach it directly to the fill level property that we have, and we're gonna call that mix tank level. So we'll go into WinCC Explorer Tag Management, and in our color tag group, we're just going to create the mix tank level tag, and we'll make that assign 16-bit value. Then, going back to Graphics Designer, we'll right-click on the dynamic for fill level and choose tag, and we'll associate that tag directly with the fill level property. Next, I'll open the tag simulator, and I'm gonna add our mixed tank level here. And we could put this on a user input function, and that'll allow us to just have a slider, and we can kind of test this out. So since I've chosen user input for the function, then you'll go down to the user input properties. I'll just configure it to be 0 to 100. That way we can test that out. Then I'll go back to Graphics Designer. We'll hit save, and we'll test that out in runtime. So I'll activate runtime. And with runtime open, we will open our tag simulator. So right now the tag is 0. And we'll check the active checkbox and then start our simulation. So for our user input, I can hit our value set, and you can see that the slider is 0 to 100. I'll check the apply value automatically, and I can move this slider, and you can see that the tank level is coming up. So that works. If you recall, our color structure contains elements for valve on, valve fail, pump on, and pump fail. And we have these for each of the red, green, and blue pumps and valves. So we're going to use those tags to animate the colors for our pumps and valves. So we'll start with the red pump. We want to turn the pump red if it's on, green if it's off, and we want it to flash yellow if it fails. We'll start with our blink mode. What we want to do is what we call shaded flashing. That just means that it will appear the same shaded color, and then it'll flash between that and the blink color. And we've set the blink color to this yellow. So I'll right click and choose Dynamic Dialog. I'm going to choose my red pump fail tag for this. And Dynamic Dialog is just a tool that will evaluate an expression, and then you can choose the appropriate data type for that expression, and it will set the property. So if we just put the tag name, this will resolve to the actual value of this tag, which is going to be true or false. So if pump fail is true, then we assume that the pump has failed. And so in that case, we want to set our flashing to shaded, and this will cause it to flash between green and yellow. I'll click OK. See our red lightning bolt, which is dynamic dialog. And then for our forecolor, this changes the color of the pump. We're going to do the same thing. I'll choose dynamic dialog. And for this one, I will choose red pump on. And it's also Boolean. And if this tag is high or true, then the pump will be on. And we'll just set the color to red. And if it's off, it will be green. So I will hit save. Next, I'll open our tag simulator again. And I have to stop the simulation. And I will add my red pump on tag. And also my red pump fail tag. These are the tags that we configured. I will activate these both, and I will switch them to user input. Then on main PDL, we'll go to runtime. I'll pull up my simulator and I'll start it. So we'll start with our red pump on. I'll go to my value set and you can see the slider 0 to 1. I'm going to just check apply automatically, send it to 1. And you can see the pump turns red. So it indicates to the user that the pump is on. And then for my red pump fail, we'll do the same thing. I'll apply that, and then you can see it showing the fail indication. If I set it back to 0, it stops doing that. So those are configured correctly. So we'll repeat the process on the red valve. Go to blink mode, choose dynamic dialog. Select our tag, and we'll choose red valve fail. And on our forecolor, we'll do the same thing, but this time we'll choose our red valve on and set our on color to red. And then we can save and go to runtime. And we'll pull up our simulator and I'll stop that. And I can choose both of our red valve fail and on tags, and it'll put them both in, set them both to user input, and activate them both, and then start our simulation. And then for our value, you can see that there's our on condition, and there's our fail condition. So let's configure the green and blue pumps and valves. The green and blue pumps and valves are going to be configured in exactly the same way. You'll just use the relevant tags. So here on our green pump, we're using the green pump fail tag to do our blinking. And the green dot pump on to show the power on or off condition for the forecolor. And then the same thing with the valve, we're using our green tags. There's my fail condition and the valve on, valve off condition. And blue is done exactly the same way. Now all we need to do is add these tags to the tag simulator and test these out. Under my color tags, I can just select all of my green tags and all of my blue tags. Then I can use my pull down feature to set them all to user input. And I can use the pull down feature here to activate all of these. Then we can start our simulation and open our runtime window. And we'll test out our green valve. Or I could actually just write a 1 directly in here. There's our fail condition. There's our green pump on. Our fail condition. There's our blue valve and fail condition. And our pump on and off and fail condition. So all of this stuff works. So the last thing we want to do is make sure that we save our simulation. And you can see here I've saved this as a file called pump valve sim, and it would allow you to name the file. But here I could just call this new pump valve sim. And that way I would be able to recall this configuration anytime that I would like.